and Chips. I'm your host, Radium. I'm with Lossor in the BBC, and he will be going over India's POV. This is round two, and we are facing quite a strong opponent today, who surprisingly lost the first match. I don't know against who, I can check. Give me a second. We are facing Belgium, as you can see on screen. Let me just check the result that Belgium got. Belgium lost to Poland. Unsurprisingly, Poland is the favorite to win the tournament overall. So it's not surprising that they lost the match against Poland. So we have to face Belgium this time. Now too, we have crowd favorite Scrappy in here. I guess everyone knows who Scrappy is. I don't think he needs an introduction. Scrappy is a streamer. He is a player for Trackmania Grand League. He is a player for Team Lazarus. So yeah, he'll be a really strong opponent. We also have AQLX, who is also really strong. We have Scandier, who is really good on campaign and on Kaki. I watched this for Kaki. He is actually really good at Kaki. We have Dofault, who was a player in the Trackmania World Cup. So a pretty strong player as well from Dofault. We also have one last guy called Nathan. I have no idea who he is. But since he's on the team, I assume he's good. So yeah, really strong opposing there. And it will be difficult for us to go through, since they are one of the best teams in this tournament. They should be able to go through to the playoffs very relatively easily. We are just in warm-up. Nothing is happening at the moment. The admin hasn't arrived on the server. So yeah, let's just wait for the admin and then we can move around. We can get to the map picks and then we will start the match after that. So you can just watch the guys who are just time attacking at the moment. So I don't think I can say much at the moment other than it's gonna be really difficult. Okay, seems that an admin has joined the server, so we should be getting our maps pretty soon. Let's see if we can try and figure out what the matches are. Hopefully we can start soon so that we don't have a lot of delay. And we do have our first ban from India, and it's not surprising to see we have banned 21 once again, which is the tech track, and Belgium bans map 12, which is our strongest map, so we lose our strongest map as well, I guess. And they pick 18. We are still waiting for India's pick. Hopefully we get it soon. And they pick 7. We have 18, 7, 23, 10, and 9. And we are skipping this round, so which means we will swap to our first map, which is 18. We have an interesting map here in form of a tech map with engine off, where you can have a skip of an engine off map. This is a unique track, and it is actually really nice to drive if you get the lines right, but the lines are pretty difficult to get it right. Especially one of the turns on around 30 to 35 seconds, where the line is actually really difficult to get. Let me just show you. We start off with a left drift, really easy, really clean. Then a small jump to the right, then another right turn. We then drop down. It is important to minimize the airtime and get up to fifth gear before this left, without this right turn with the engine off, so that you would maximize your speed. We then have a left turn, and this is the turn that is really important. You have to decelerate and drift to the left. We then follow it with a jump and a turn to the right, and another turn to the right with a little jump, a small turn to the left with another drift to the left. With coming up is the infamous engine off skip that I mentioned, as Corpit does not go for the engine off skip because he does not have enough speed. So that engine off can be skipped with a lot of speed going through to the ending, and you have a small drift to the left of the ending there. That is a lap or a round around map 18. So I have seen our guys practice on here. Corpit and Nami are good, I would say, normally. So let's see if our boys can pump a good map out and get some confidence in them, because this is a difficult map. So yeah, 40 seconds left in warm-up. Let's go to the live ground and I'll continue the cast. Okay, since we are going live with our first round against Belgium, we have who are our players actually. I don't have names. That's wonderful. So we have Joffre Trappi and Candia playing for Belgium. We have Nami, not curious, and Corpid. As Nami goes for a little wall test there, that's not good. Corpid also goes for a wall test, it's not good, and I think this is Belgium's round here at the moment. And yeah, not a good start at the moment for us. I'm not gonna commentate a lot on a dead round because purely just Trappi going for an engine off just to BM. And yeah, that should be a clean Belgium round. 1 minute to Belgium. Let's see, I'm not sure if our boys will finish. They will. At least two of them will. I'm not sure about Corporate Belgium. I think he has DNF out of frustration. Okay, not a good start. Obviously, I'm not going to sugarcoat it. That was a terrible start for us. But let's see if we can bring it back in the next round. Okay, round 2 of our match against Belgium on map 18. We have a good start from all 3 Belgium players. That is not good to see. Scorpion still lagging on my screen as Nami and Nocturius both go for the same wall touch. I don't think that's intentional at all. And they are losing a lot of speed. Fortunately, Joffre is also made a mistake, but it's not enough. As Belgium secured P1 and P2 at the moment. And that is enough for a map win. As Nami goes for another touch and another touch. So now this Nami's round done. Corpid is still lagging. I'm not sure where he is on the screen. I'm not willing to package him. And Nocturius is behind Joffre, who then does no slide. And yeah, I don't think this map is going to be going really smoothly for us. I think we did pick this map. Oh, we didn't pick this map. This was Belgium's pick and we picked 7. So hopefully the guys can either get the map really quickly and go to the next map and hopefully they can perform a bit better. So yeah, not a good start to Belgium at the moment. Yeah, a good start from our boys. We have Nami who is in close contention with all 3 but losing a lot of speed to them as they are all pulling away from Nami slowly. Nami is currently in P4 and I am not sure where Scorp is. Scorp is still lagging, I guess. The children is not really doing good at the moment. So yeah, I think this is another Belgium round. They have clean swept us. Case does as Nami actually grinds the wall. It's not good. Nocturius not going for the best lines as Corpid leaves the game, which means his endurance is really bad. So yeah, not looking good. I'm not sure if we could do some damage on this map, but let's see. Best to just throw away this match behind us and hope for a good match at round 7. At map 7, which is in our second match. Okay. Let's go, round 4. As you see, Nami actually going for a touch on the drift. Corpid and Nocturus far behind. About 2-3 tenths behind, 4 tenths behind even. This is a great showing from Belgium actually as they lock out first, top 3 with Candier leading and Trappi P2 and with Joffre in P3. We have not Corpid in P4 and as Candier makes a mistake, but that doesn't matter since Belgium has P1 and P2. Nocturne is also making mistakes, so our round is definitely lost. Corpid may overtake Joffre here if he has more speed on the exit, but he doesn't, and Joffre does secure P2 for Belgium, which means another Belgium round. 4 rounds in a row for Belgium. Not looking good for us, but yeah. Thank you. Okay, round 5. This is Belgium's on match point, but they are bonking. They are hitting the wall, which is good for us. Carpet is in P2 with Scrappy leading. Scrappy did touch before the engine now, so he's gonna lose a lot of speed. And Carpet overtakes the lead from Scrappy. Nami is in P2, 1 second behind, so it's not a good round at all. Carpet actually does make a mistake, and they are catching up with some speed. They may overtake. Hopefully, Carpet can maintain the lead, but Candier is coming really close. Candier overtakes for the lead at this trip. Candier does go for, does keep the engine off. As Carpet also pumps, and it's another Belgium 1-2. And Belgium secures the match. Secures the map. 5-0 from Belgium, absolutely clinical from them. They did win all rounds consecutively. And yeah, hopefully our guys can pick up their socks and do well in our map pick, which is map 7. So yeah, let's see. We are on to map 7 right now. We have 2 minutes of warm up where I will briefly describe the map for you. And wait. Okay, we'll have a map switch since we are not on a dedicated server. But yeah, next match is map 7. We are in. This is map 7. So I'll just go over a brief overview. We have a small cut in the start, which is not really viable for rounds. But let's see how it goes. Starting off with a small downhill with a reactor boost as Carpet goes flying, tries to skip but doesn't work out. Let's try that again. Through Albert's POV, we have a small reactor boost into a water, into a reset with a small right turn, which is important to keep the gear here. If you don't keep the gear, you're gonna lose the speed, but it's not the end of the world. We then have a dirt turnover into a dirt wall rise, into a ring checkpoint, into a small platform section, where then the track moves to the right with a small downhill right-hander, and then into the finish. Track is relatively short, about 24-25 seconds. And the speeds that they reach are actually really fast, so this is actually a really quick map, that we can say. And Alba doesn't really do a lot of good warm-up. Yeah. 1 minute left into warm-up, so let's see how he goes. Let's just follow Scrappy for the moment, since he is actually practicing it. So After the finish, the cars actually go into a nice swim. Should be really refreshing for them. Let's see a kind of competitive round. Have the start, the reactor, the reset, and then we have to smooth steer into the dirt and he bonks. Man, whenever I say someone is gonna have a competitive round, they bonk. It's like I am the new caster sorcerer, but I'm not casting anything. Nice. Okay, well at least let's see a slow round for Scrappy, because yes, Scrappy stands for slow. You can see the ending actually is really important to go really low into the dirt ending to make sure that you have the shortest line to the end so that you save a lot of time. The speed you gain from going high is not worth it and shows some Scrappy's line. Warm up is done. Let's go on to round 1 of map 2. We have Nami with a late start, I guess. And Nami has DC'd. Wait, Nami has late started and Nami has DC'd. He has asked for an end round. I'm not sure if they're gonna get an end round. But yeah, everyone is finishing, so I don't think we're gonna get an end round. So it is gonna be a Belgium round.
Oh shit, we're live. Okay. Wait, somebody was AFK. Yeah, there are only 6 players playing. Wait. Dolfold. Dolfold, where did you just drive? Oh my god. I want the double Discord ping, man. Troll. Are you a troll, Anonymous? Dolfold is betting on India right now. Oh god.
Nami didn't start on time. So I guess this is a Belgium round. as Cathy has mentioned in chat, that we can't race 10 round on a non-dedicated server. So let's go, we are already on a deficit, great. Let's see if the start from the Indian boys, Indian boys have a great start. Cracky did bonk after the dirt right hander. We have Nami in T1 and Scorpion in T2 with Albert Salva really close behind. So it's an Indian P1, P2, PT locking out the front row and the third place. We have actually Scandair and Alba getting the exact same time for P3, but Albatross does clinch that position due to his name. I'm not sure of that, but let's see if that is true. We have our first Indian round.
Some of the Indian players ruled end round, please. It's, yeah, we're playing on a non-dedicated server. How is that gonna work? Oops. Wait. Uh-oh, this is a very short map. Wait, is that Dofold? Dofold, what are we doing here? Why is there three Indians up front? Yeah, so we just got swept by India. Wait, 40 what? Wait, 24.1? Wait, 0.1?
I'm not sure if Belgium, they gave that to us for free, but let's see. I'm not gonna comment. Round 3. Alba doesn't get a good start, but is really neck and neck with all three of them. Cockpit and Alba in the top with Nami battling for the final places, which is important. Alba in the lead, going for a tight line, which is, and maintains speed, and the Russ gets P1, but it is not enough as Belgium close out P2, P3 and P4, which means they get 12 points, which is one more than 11 that is needed to win a round.
That's fast. Yo, how is he so far ahead? Wait. Dude! Okay, we win the round though. We win the round. Okay, they are fast. Holy shit. Holy shit, guys.
2-1 to Belgium at the moment. Round 4. These rounds will go off really quickly since the match is really small. And we can see a lot of changing and swapping and changing happening in the positions as well. As we see, not a good start from the Indian boys this time. We are near the bottom, but we are gaining in speed. Nami and Scorpion with a really good line as someone has respawned. I assume it is Dofolt or AQLX. As Scrappy takes P1, Nami P2, Scorpion P3, but Alba finishing in P5 is all that is needed for us to win around.
They have practiced this map. Bomb! Come on! Wait, we lost. No fault!
Great times by Scrappy and by Nami. Scrappy with a 0.0, which is about 0.5 or 0.6 behind WR. Really good time for rounds. Let's see if we can continue our good streak here. 2-2 for now. Round 5 here. As Scorpion doesn't really get a good start, I think he comes the outside, which will lose him from speed. As Nami overtakes the lead here with a nice outside line, a high line to the wall ride. A tight line to the ending will secure P1, but I don't think that will matter because Belgium has P2, P3 and P4. And it will not. Belgium secures another round, which is round 3 at the moment. They do have 3 points. India on 2 points, but the match is really close.
Tutu. Oh no, that's not a good turn for me. Oh, but saved. Wait, what the fuck is that guy doing? Dude, calm the fuck down? Hello? All right, we have Belgium behind them. We're here with the lineup. Okay, another round for Belgium. We're good. Holy shit, this is a close match. It's a best of five.
Let's see how they can do. This match is really good, and it's really nice to see that both teams are competitive. This is the kind of match that we need to see. Strati with a lot of speed out of the reactor boost gets a huge head start. Hopefully we can catch up. Dofault is in P2, preventing us from any lead. And Naomi is in P2 at the moment, who is currently battling with Dofault. Hopefully he can gather P2, but we don't have P4, which means that this will again be another Belgium round, and Belgium goes on with 4 points, plus having match point.
You're losing all your points betting against your own country. Imagine. Okay, really good start for me. Right, nice. Okay, let's do it.
India will need to win all 3 rounds of the next 3 rounds in order to have a chance of winning. Let's see if they can do it. If not, the luck. Let's see. Round 7. Good start from Albatross. He needs to step up, to be honest, because it is currently not enough to have only 2 people in the top. Alba currently doing well. P3, P4 around that area. This is what we need. Corbin and Naomi holding P2 and P3, and that should be around. And yes, it is. We did secure 11 points, which is what is needed for a round win. And that is our 3rd round. On our way to a mini comeback. We need to win 2 more rounds in order to get a comeback.
NL got clapped 3-0. Yikes. Oh my god, the entirety of Team India is right behind me. I'm driving out of my mind, you're gonna stop? Oh my god, we lost! Holy shit! 0.2, 0.3, 0.4. God damn! Alright, not over yet, chat.
Round 8 right now. Let's see, of course, Dofault with not a good start. He does get a lot of poor speed out of the corner. So, let's see how good Crafty actually. With a great start, Dofault actually brings it all back even with a poor start. And Belgium is locking in all of the top places. And it is a Belgium round.
Well, the people that went all in on Belief, man, they must be sweating right now. But I must say, guys, I didn't expect them to be this good either, so... Oof. Oh my god, I nearly died. Ah, this is looking like it. This should be the GG, guys. Team Belgium is here. Yeah. It's definitely GG. There's no way we fail the end this hard. Alright. G. To the G.
And the match switch that has happened. We are going to go into 23 right now in a few seconds. And there you go. We are into the map. 23 is a bit of an ice map. We have a small bobsleigh section. We have a small ice wall ride. And yeah. I believe Scorpid is pretty good. Scorpid is pretty good on all the maps. But he just lacks the consistency. He's more of a time attack hunter, I would say, just lacks the consistency to do good at the moment, which is why we are not really go too far. So yeah, in warm-up I just go through the map. We have a small water drop, which is actually really cool. Do a small dirt section to reset the waterways, that is actually important. We then have a nice bobsleigh section with a smooth bobsleigh line. Then goes into a platform section with grass. Small grass section with another ice jump into an ice wall ride. This wall ride is important because it is important to carry speed onto the next ice slide, which is actually really deadly, as you can lose your slide and lose your gear a lot over this section, which can cause you a lot of pain. We then have a jump into a grass section into another jump. We then have another bump staying to the right, and then comes the finish with some reactor boost to boost some speed and a water jump. come across the line. That is a pretty good time for Scorpion. 49.4 is comparative even on the leaderboards. Let's see if we can replicate that in round. In seconds into warm up, and we can go live with map 3, I believe. This is match point for Belgium. If they win this match, they will win the whole round. So it's do or die for India at the moment. Let's see. To start with Dofert, he gets the proper speed set on the water. Belgium having top 3 positions, but the follow up grab. Nami overtakes one of the Belgian guys and goes up into P2. With a lot of speed and overtakes, not crappy, but has a lot of air time, so you lose some time. We have a good spacing with our guys with 1-3. We hold 1-3 and 5, so this should be enough to win the round. Let's see if they can hold it. Nami actually loses the slide and ends up losing first place. Scorpion and Neha Rehan in P3 and P4. Rehan goes for a really high jump, loses a lot of speed. Scorpion is overtaking AQLS, or is he? I guess he is. He's having a lot of speed and he has a good line in the ending. But AQLS really is just sniping in the end. And it is not an Indian round as Belgium secure P1 and P2. Nami loses his ice slide in the middle and just GLS. Or did he? He didn't. He finished with 1:09. But yeah, still a Belgian round since they did get P1 and P2. So, let's continue. Hopefully they can bring it back in the next round. So, Dofert getting a really good start, getting 4th gear after the dirt. This gives you a lot of speed through the box lane, and Belgium do secure P1 and P2 on the start. Actually, even P3, as AQLX does have more speed than Nami. Nami currently losing a lot of speed to AQLX, with Rehan pretty far behind, about 6 tenths behind for round 4 test behind, as Nami does crash. Not good. Rehan loses his ice slide, and Scorpion also loses his ice slide. Not a good map for India. And Belgium do have P1, P2 and P3 again, and they are on the way to win another round. Second round on the board for Belgium, not looking good for India at the moment. We need to win the next few rounds in order to get our confidence back, but let's see if that happens. Two rounds done, on to round 3. We see the Belgian boys going for a better start overall, since they are consistently able to keep both gear over the dirt. That is something that is lacking from the boys from India, as Rappi does get an acceleration penalty on the bobsleigh, so he is out of the round for now. We have Scorpion in P3 closely fighting with AQLX and Dofert, and Nami close behind them as well. Scorpion overtakes someone as they overtake him back. Goes for a good ice slide and gets a really good ice slide through the section. Gets a lot of speed, carries the speed through the jumps, and he is safely in P1 with Nami in P3. This is important, as Nami needs to get P3 in order for us to have a chance. As Rehan is currently in P6, we will only get 1 point, so Nami will have to secure P3, and he does. All that is here is Rehan has to finish, and we'll have our first draw on the board on this map. Great to see Scorpion back with a good time. A 49.0 is a nice time in rounds. And AQLX is 1/10 behind, but let's see. Good round indeed. First round for India on the board on this map. Let's see if we can continue this form, as we really do need the form, as this is a great match indeed. Okay, round 4, let's see what happens. Belgium with another good start. They are so good at that starts. They are really trained on this match. It shows really well. But Scorpion actually gets a lot of speed over the box play and overtakes the lead, goes for a really high line on the wall right, goes for a really shallow ice slide, gets a lot of exit speed, but doesn't take a lot of the booster, so you not get a lot of exit speed out of the ice slide. And Belgium, all three Belgian players overtake Scorpion once again. Kapil goes to a really low jump. It was actually really scary, as he might have fully died there, but he didn't. Kapil does actually catch Trappi, but he's not going to overtake him. He has a bad lane for the ending, and another Belgian round. Not being able to capitalize on the momentum, that sucks, but it is what it is. Belgium gets their third round of the map. Only need two more to finish fully close out the match, indeed. Let's see how they go. On to round 5. Here we go then, round 5. Belgium need 2 more points to secure the match. India need 4 more points to secure this map or the 4th map. I don't remember the next map, but whatever the next map is, I assume it's map 10. Let's see. Again, Belgium with a good start. Scrappy with another acceleration penalty on the box play. Parfit does have a really good engineer out of the box play and does have a lot of speed, so he's catching to Rofel, but he has a weird line through that ice jump and does lose a lot of speed. KKLX does catch him again. Parfit going for a nice slide. That's a really good ice slide, gets a lot of the boosters, gets a lot of speed out of the ice as well, but AQLX just get it insanely well, much better than Scorpion did. Both for a really low jump, both of them, and it is neck and neck for the win. Rehan is in P4, which is important. He needs that P4 as Scorpion does go for the overtake and does have a better line and does secure PD1. Rehan, if Rehan finishes in P4, he does, and Nami needs to finish in P5, he doesn't. Another Belgian round, I assume. Wait. AQLX overtook Scorpion. What? When did this happen? By 1700th of a second, that's really good by AQLX. He had a really good ending, I assume, with the speed slide on the ending. Yeah, I didn't even see that, so that's a Belgian round by default. Round 6 now, Belgium on 4 points, India on 1 point. Belgium needs to win this round in order to close the match. India needs to win the next 4 rounds in order to close the next match. Really difficult to see this match go like this, but let's see how it goes. Scorpion with another good buff this section, gets a lot of speed through there and overtakes P1. He's on P1 at the moment, goes to a very high lane, goes for a lot of extra speed and does carry a lot of speed over the ice sled, which is coming in right now. Scorpion goes to a really high line, which is not really optimal, and he does get a good line. He has to bounce, as Nami also bounced, and that is Belgium's round. Once again, and Belgium snap as well. Belgium do have 1, 2 and 3, I guess, and that is true. Belgium throws it out in 3 maps, really quick style. That was good from Belgium, not really good from India, but what can I say, Belgium was a really tough opponent and it was inevitable that India would. I am an India supporter, but I have to say that Belgium is a really good team and it was a fantastic match from Belgium. We just didn't have the pace or didn't have the consistency in order to win that match. And yeah, that's it. Round 2 is done. That was a quick one. But next time, we can, hopefully next match, we can get a good team so that we can have some sort of a chance, to be honest. We will come back to you after a short break with the next match. We will inform on Discord as well if you want to get notified. Get ready to join the Discord. If you haven't, we have a good Indian community over there. And yeah, we'll be back after a short break.